This is the story of your enslavement, how it came to be, and how you can finally be free. To be truly free is both very easy and very hard. We avoid the horror of our enslavement because it is so painful to see it directly. We dance around the endless violence of our dying system because we fear the attacks. But we can only be kept in the cages we refuse to see. Wake up.
What's in a woman? Women carry a worth more prestigious than fine stones. We are landmarks of triumph and integrity, humility, beauty, never to be merely reduced to something enticing to the male eye. She loves the idea of love, and so she continuously falls into the trap of loving prematurely. I think he loves me. This woman wears her huge red heart pumping blood down her sleeve. No bandages big enough to cover these emotional wounds. She's fragile. Hold this way up, she can't hold her head up for hope, because it seems that everything on this earth is broken. Everything on this earth is broken. She's been carrying brokenness for so long. She's lost sense of what whole smells like, feels like, sounds like. A beautiful.
Dreamt of a dawn. Since the moment the seed took root in the earth.
I am the soil.
I am the sky.
I am the mountain.
I am water.
I am ice.
I am the rainforest.
I am a flower.
I am corn.
I am on a journey, as we all are, to a place that often seems impossible to find. For so long, I have simply existed, just another grain of sand blowing in the wind. And then, something in me began to change. My eyes opened to a new horizon, and I came to a realization. The earth has a heartbeat. It feels, it breathes, it hears, and sometimes it speaks.
Some call me nature. Others call me Mother Nature. I've been here for over 4.5 billion years. 22,500 times longer than you. I don't really need people, but people need me. Yes, your future depends on me. When I thrive, you thrive. When I falter, you falter. My oceans, my soil, my flowing streams, my forests, they all can take you or leave you. How you choose to live each day, whether you regard or disregard me, doesn't really matter to me. One way or the other, your actions will determine your fate, not mine. I am nature. I will go on. I am prepared to evolve. Are you?
I am the soil. I am in the hills and in the valleys, the farms, the orchards. Without me, humans could not exist. But you treat me like dirt. Do you realize that I am just a thin skin on this planet? And that I'm actually alive? Full of organisms that grow your food? But I am broken, aching, overused, sick. Because of you. You have withered me away to less than half of what I used to be just over 100 years ago. I am turning to dust. So maybe you could treat me with a little more respect. Are you paying attention?
Look up. There I am. I am the sky. I am a warm protective blanket wrapped around everyone on Earth. I can bring clouds, rain, and wind. I can be an ice storm. Without me, you'd fry. Every day, I am the breath you take in. Yet you are making me sick. You see, I am more delicate than you think. It took millions of years to get it just right. But now your cars, your factories, and dust, they have pushed me past the limit. I have become unpredictable. Give me a few thousand years. I have weathered trauma before. I am not worried for myself. Look up.
I am the mountain. I am nature's oldest temple. My glaciers and streams provide the water you drink. My forests, your wood, your clean air. From up here, I see how you've come to treat this world. You used to recharge your body and soul in the calm of my forests. You once climbed my peaks, seeking enlightenment. Now you take what you want and contemplate only your own gain. Open your eyes while there's still time. Because there's one more thing I see clearly. The cliff you're on and the rocks below.
I am water. To humans, I am simply just there. I'm something they just take for granted. But there is only so much of me. And more of them every single day. I start as rain in the mountains, flow to the rivers and streams, and end up in the ocean. Then the cycle begins again. And it will take me 10,000 years to get back to the state I'm in now. But to humans, I'm just water. Just there. Where will humans find me when there are billions more of them around? Where will they find themselves? Will they wage wars over me, like they do over everything else? That's always an option. But it's not the only option.
I am ice. I move slowly. I keep the world cool. Well, I used to. But humans keep warming this planet. I try to warn you. I send pieces of me thundering into the ocean. You do nothing. I raise sea levels. You do nothing. It has taken you decades to notice. Perhaps I'm not so slow after all.
I am the rainforest. I watched them grow up here. They've left, but they always come back. Yes, they always come back. For my trees, their wood, my plants, their medicines. For my beauty, their escape. I've always been there for them. And I have been more than generous. Sometimes I gave it all to them. Now, gone forever. Jungles, trees. Well, they do breathe air, and I make air. Have they thought about that? Humans, so smart. They'll figure it out. making air. That'll be fun to watch.
I am a flower. I'm worshipped for my looks, my scent. But here's the thing. Life starts with me. You see, I feed people. Every fruit comes from me. Every potato, me. Every kernel of corn, me. Every grain of rice, me. And sometimes I feed their souls. I am their words when they have none. I say I love you without a sound. I'm sorry without a voice. I inspire the greatest of them. Painters, poets, pattern makers, I've been amused to them all. But in my experience, people underestimate the power of a pretty little flower. Because their life does start with me. And it could end without me.
I am coral. Some people think I'm just a rock. When in fact, I'm the largest thing alive on this planet. I'm so big I can be seen from space. But for how long? I grew for almost 250 million years. And humans came along, and now one-fifth of me is gone. Sure, I live at the bottom of the sea. And you might not see me that often. But you do need me. I'm the protein factory for the world. Yet you raised the temperature of the ocean, so I can't live here anymore. And when big storms and tsunamis barrel through the ocean, I'm your fortress. Yet you tear me apart with dynamite and poison me with cyanide. Well, here's a crazy thought. Stop killing me.
I am home. I give you comfort. I shelter your family. See me for who I am. Home, sweet home. I am your refuge. I am the floor that supports you. The foundation that keeps you steady. The walls that give you shelter. The roof that protects you. I am your home. If you don't take care of me, I cannot take care of you.